Can you talk about your experiences making Pride and Prejudice? Because it was a project that a lot of people had trepidation about. There'd been the classic miniseries before, and it was, as you said yourself, a much beloved classic.
Yeah, it was terrifying. And I think, you know, particularly with books like that, but particularly Pride and Prejudice, you know, people who love it see themselves as Elizabeth Bennet, you know. So you are never going to be the image that they have of Elizabeth Bennet, because it will be them. So it was terrifying going into it. And
how much were you able to bring your version of Elizabeth Bennet to
the
part?
Well, it was something that I'd been absolutely obsessed by since I was, I think, about 7 or 8. And in fact, I had a doll's house at home that was Pemberley, and I had all the characters in, and it has a miniature version. My mum still has it at home. It has a miniature version of Pride and Prejudice in it. So it really was, it had been a complete and utter obsession. I'm dyslexic, so I hadn't actually read the novel, but I had it on book tape. And again, just used to listen to the book tape over and over and over and over and over. So I had a very clear sense of who she was, because she was me, you know, as she is everybody else, you know, she was me. So I did know that I wanted, I knew what I wanted to do, but it was still a terrifying thing.
And your collaboration with Joe, did it permit that kind of creative passion to come through for Elizabeth?
Yeah, I mean, I think with Joe, you know, he at that particular point, being a teenager who's come out of sort of big blockbuster films, there was a lot of criticism and a lot of people saying she's shit, she can't act, she can't do it, what's the point, she's pouty, she's thin. And of course, being a teenager, you do read it all and you do listen to it all and you go, oh my God, I'm that awful. I really am that awful. And, you know, Joe was the first person, actually with John Mabry, I mentioned a film just before called The Jacket, and I've worked with John Mabry twice, and I had both of them back to back, who went, put your head down, work, you can do this, prove them wrong. And, you know, anybody needs that kind of support, and I was incredibly lucky to have got it at 19, you know, at that particular time, where they just went, you can do it. And that belief really, really was sort of, has meant so much, and continues to. You know, I've made 3 films with Joe and 2 films with John, and they've both been amazing.